name is Jared. This is Luke Finley, and last but not least, we have Owen over here. Yeah, we're going to be making the automated parking management system. Now, I'm sure everybody here can agree with me that nobody likes to sit in their car when traffic or sitting in a line waiting in a queue to get in the parking lot. And we did a little bit of research and studying and found that a study by IBM showed that a significant amount of traffic is actually caused by people searching for available parking spaces and parking lots. And that was the issue we were trying to solve. Now, this results in a lost productivity and time, which of course is money. And we wanted to make this entire experience of parking a little bit more seamless and hands-free. So we wanted to achieve this with four objective points, which can be seen here as the parking space availability recognition, which is a little bit self-explanatory, as well as parking violation recognition to automatically issue tickets when necessary. Automation, which is a big one. We want the system to be autonomous, where if you don't want necessarily want an employee to have their hands on it, it can operate fully automatically. And of course, adaptability. We want to be able to adapt it to whether it be parking garages, indoor spaces, outdoor spaces, wherever it is needed. And we plan on achieving this using a two-part solution, which comprised of a wirelessly transmitting and rotating HD camera, which is connected to LPR software, which stands for license plate recognition. And that works in conjunction with the database in order to determine, as I mentioned earlier, parking violations, open space recognition, etc. And Luke here is going to further explain those two subsystems.
So on the bottom left is our design of the camera system. And you can see we simulated parking space. And we have cars in each spot. And then in the middle, above the lane, is an alert system with an attached camera. And what happens is the camera will move from space to space and take photos and send that back to our database where the LPR software is. And then that'll be analyzed. And the cable, the motor, the camera's attached to the cable that rotates. And also has settings for the correct distance to move, so it knows when to stop at the next phase. It also has settings for the correct timing to move, so if the traffic's there's more traffic, we can speed it up to take more photos and send more data. And then the camera will wirelessly transmit the photo back to the database. And the camera also has settings so it's in sync with the motor, so it knows when to take the photo. And then on the right, we have a flow chart of how our analysis will work. And with the LPR software, it'll identify from the photos sent from the camera, it'll identify if a car's parked, it'll identify the license plate number, and identify the camera system, what space it took us to know what the permit access is for the car. With database, most databases, when you get a parking permit, you have to register your vehicle, so you register where your license plate number is. So when we identify the license plate number of the car, we can match up our database and figure out what their permit is, and then we can figure out if they're parked illegally and buy them, notify them. And then also, when the software figures out if a space is open or taken, then we can update our parking availability, and then that can be distributed to let people know how many parking spaces are available and where they are. And then for the violations, we'll notify whenever we figure out that a violation is happening.
Go ahead.
So in conclusion, all those things will accomplish all the objectives that we have up there.
Okay, so my question is, I think I understand what you said, that you're going to have a camera that's basically on, whether it's a cable or something else, it's going to be on a racetrack that's going to cover the entire parking area. Mm-hmm. It seems like a huge installation issue for whoever it is that's been parking a lot. You know, if we're talking about street parking in the city, we're talking about some sort of cable that goes up and down the street, if we're talking about a parking garage that has multiple levels and hundreds of parking places, it seems like a huge amount of infrastructure to be putting in for this.
Perhaps you can put it in your drawer or something and You sure want some camera running around, giving even less clearance?
Yeah.
And there'd be one less camera.
No question.
So if you go to the UTV parking lot, they already have a system like this where they can find out if you're lengthy and go to the airport, it tells you which lot of empty and so forth. Now, how is this strategy different?
Well, I mean, if you go downtown, most of the parking lots now, they're either managed by people, I mean, you have to have employees to manage the lots, or, you know, you have those little slots where you, you know, put money in, people illegally park all the time, and, you know, you're never caught. I mean, I've been late buying the parking passes up here, and, you know, park up here a few weeks without having a proper pass. I never even, you know, never get a ticket for it. And
how come I always do?
I got one now.
Do you extract a number from license plate by system or some operator that have?
We're going to use the camera, and that's going to wirelessly transmit the photo, and we're going to extract the characters in that software instead of directly through the camera.
On your open space recognition, I'm thinking downtown Dallas or someplace that's not like the airport where they have little lights above their stall. But how are you telling people that you've got this traffic congestion because people are looking for spots, you've got a smart system, however it's designed and it's working, how are you telling the people where to go find the spot that's three blocks that way and two streets over, when, because they're going to be hunting for
yeah.
it. If they can see it, if they're close enough to see it, then they've already found it.
Yeah, well, I mean, we discussed that a little bit, and our idea behind that was if there were parking, because we're going to keep track of the available spaces and, you know, within the system, and then we were kind of thinking maybe implement a sign or something that would be connected to the system potentially. I mean, that was just an idea we threw out there, but we weren't really sure how to handle that yet.
Seems like something, I'm using GPS, I'm trying to go find a parking spot, and the system interacts with my GPS and says parking spot,
yeah.
and it tells my GPS where to go to park there.